Welcome to Bubble Man's World. Johnny B is in the house.
Puff Wednesday,
dude.
For 2015.
Dude, holy smokes.
The first Puff Wednesday.
When's the last time we even did a Puff Wednesday?
Shit, you know what happened there is we were getting ready to go to Amsterdam, and you went to Jamaica, and it's been a few
Toronto.
Months.
Toronto.
We got busy, and
you fell and hurt yourself.
Hurt myself, and just a bunch of... It's been a while.
It has been a while, but here we are, Puff Wednesday. You guys asked, and we are... giving you your request. We're not exactly sure what we're going to do today. We might head on down to Mega Ill Pizza and order ourselves some medicated pizza and cheesecake, as that was such a good time last time.
That cheesecake was amazing.
It was really tasty, really a great vibe all in all, and I hope that we can make that happen today. But we figured, because we were sitting here puffing bowls and eating CBD caramels from the Great Gardener and sweetgrass extracts. Thank you, Sarah, for these beautiful gifts that you shared with us up in Whistler. I'm going to have a little bit of a problem because they were in my pocket, but should be able to...
Yeah, I can already see I'm going to get into this here.
You know what? I don't mind having a tiny little bit of parchment paper. I can just peel it off with my nails. There we go. So, yeah, we were sitting here talking about the Instagram deletion, the great deletion of Instagram cannabis accounts.
Big accounts, small accounts, little accounts. It's just amazing what's going on with Instagram. They're just deleting accounts.
We saw the High Society, who has almost 300,000 followers, has only 8 photos. Was good to see his account was up, though.
All the followers were backwards before it was just gone.
I couldn't find Weedstagram. There's definitely something going on with Instagram, so... I personally was just telling John how I stopped really posting on Instagram daily about maybe 6 months ago. And as you guys know, I've been posting a lot more videos. I'm really more attuned to this sort of interaction that we can get on Facebook. But that would still bum me out big time if my Instagram account got deleted.
Hell yeah. You know what? Like, a lot of people put a lot of work into it, but we're even talking about whose accounts are being deleted and which ones are still there.
Well, that's just it, right?
Right? We're seeing some big accounts being deleted, and we're seeing, is it the advertising part that they're doing? Is it the weed content? Well, I know the one account that was recently deleted was the MedChainer account, and they don't have just weed. They have a lot of everything else on there, and I really came to think about it. Like, they don't always do all marijuana, but everything they do is advertising. Hmm. Every post is advertising. So is there something around that with the advertising? Because your Instagram is golden. It's beautiful.
There's... Today it is, but maybe tomorrow it's not. Let's fingers crossed. If BC Bubble Man disappears, I'll definitely open up another account and post all those photos as well. I managed to, I was telling John earlier, I keep all my Instagram account photos
right there
in an account. So I have, this is just from 2014 here, but I have all the years of my photos from the months of my Instagram uploads. And I do that because a lot of times the way people get in touch with me, they see my stuff on Instagram and then they want to either get a collaboration going for like a clothing line, or they want to acquire a photo for a magazine or a book. And they'll often be like, oh, here's the picture I want. And then I have to know
exactly
where in my photos, and I have 80,000 photos, over 15 to 17 years, cannabis photos.
Huge.
It becomes a little bit ridiculous. Minor stress. And it's always the one they want, was always the one I could never find.
Of course.
So I went through all of them and added them into this folder. So, and now it's an easy thing whenever I...
So that's a really good idea. If you have your Instagram account, you're a little bit scared, you have the folders on.
It's a great idea. As you load accounts, you know, it's a bit of a pain in the butt because most people do that Instagram solely through a phone.
Well, for me, my Instagram, 420 Weedmaster, is nothing but my grow logs.
Right.
That's what I've used it for. Yeah. So I don't advertise. I've used it as my grow logs.
And
so
you're not breaking any law.
No, I'm just... And that was another thing we talked about. is the legalities in, say, the U.S., in Europe, or in
mm-hmm.
Canada.
Sure.
I mean, we know in Canada we're legal. I'm a legal medical patient, so
yep.
I'm doing nothing wrong.
For all we know, the feds approached Instagram and said, take down all the pod accounts. People are using that. You know, maybe they don't want that in the U.S. I don't know.
We don't know.
Europe also, though, we know High Society and Weedstagram are in Amsterdam.
Exactly.
So that's kind of freaky.
It is freaky.
A little bit freaky, but let's just puff bowls and not think about that too much.
Well, what I liked was, you know, your little backup program and what people can do. Just, you know what, get on top of it. Make sure you back up your files or share it on another platform.
That's it. You ready for some Warlock?
I'm waiting for some Warlock.
Give
it
to
Warlock.
It's okay. It's you nice. Had the Congo.
I had Congo when I first walked in here. Haven't dabbed it yet, been growing it, but definitely have not had a good dab of it.
Nice. Well, here is some Warlock for Johnny B on a Puff Wednesday. Johnny B brought me a few plants as well. Now, two that I've been waiting to get back for a little bit here, which was the Congo and the Jamaican cut that I gave him originally. I think you were the first person I gave that cut to, so go figure you would be the first one to give it back.
Well...
Good one.
You said, I don't have the Jamaican. The first thing I said was, I have to bring it to you.
Yep.
You have to have it. That's the first one that you need to have. So, and of course, the Congo, which is just such a sweet smelling, tasting strain.
Dude, I love it.
Very, very nice. It's a great way to welcome in 2015 with some beautiful genetics.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
But I'm gonna...
I might crack some seeds this year.
I just cracked a new seed. It just
nice.
Popped.
What is it?
It'll be something, it's going to be something new. It's definitely something that's going to, well, I gotta see how it's going to taste.
Oh, is this the one that your Congo crossed?
That's
that
the Congo
that
cross.
You don't know what crossed it.
Don't know what
crossed it. You didn't see any males or any hammers?
I'm thinking the banana, and if there was one, might have came off the My Little Pony beside it, and that would have been in my grow back in September. So I was definitely checking that out, and I do have, and it wasn't like a lot because I smoked the whole plant, of course, and I got like 6 seeds. And it was one side and one bud, so it was the one bud that got a little bit of pollen on.
What My Little Pony?
Number 4 pheno.
Oh, thank God.
So we're going to get sticky against sticky, so we'll see whatever happens.
I know that, it'll be nice to see some Congo, new Congo things.
New Congo things.
You know, if maybe the people that aren't into the Congo being out there, maybe they'll be okay with like a nice Congo cross being out there.
Maybe.
I just hit the JT15
with
Justin Trudeau.
Justin Trudeau.
Yeah, you want to hit the Justin Trudeau?
I'll hit Justin. He supports legalization of marijuana, so.
Well, he's a politician trying to win an election during a time that cannabis is the hot topic. I'm not quite sure that that has everything to do with his personal agenda, but I can definitely say that only a few years ago he had a more negative tone when it came to cannabis. I'm happy to hear that he has a positive tone, but I get in trouble for this often. I'm really not a believer. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'll support the party that everyone's supporting for cannabis. But I'm just not a believer that even voting people in gets them in. I'm a believer that people who create that sort of power aren't going to let it go so readily or easily. Just my own personal opinion. Feel free to fire some accusational, sociopathic, borderline insane comments.
The whole platform a little dangerous where their conservative government is issuing licensed producer contracts to all these licensed producers, and Trudeau is screaming legalization, and what we're going to have is, well, everybody should just grow their own marijuana.
Well, you know what? I love that idea.
Cannabis, up here in Canada, everything is marijuana, and that's why I was just saying it. I was just on my mind, and I always refer to it as cannabis because it is my medicine. But, I mean, there's definitely a fight going on up here in Canada where the U.S. is actually legalizing certain states, and the feds are like, okay, fine, we're done.
Here's the problem I have with thinking that everyone could grow cannabis.
Well,
it's you yourself have a pension, so you don't have to work, and you are able to spend an enormous amount of time focused on your love and passion of cannabis.
It, exactly.
Could you imagine if you didn't have that? Like, just think of
I couldn't do it.
That's what I'm saying. I'd say 80% of the people out there, maybe more, are not in our position. to be able to just, like, my desk is covered in hash. There's plants over there. There's plants over there. There's plants downstairs. There's hash everywhere. This is like my sole focus. I'm able to, like, focus on it. And still, I find it very difficult to grow enough high-quality resin just for myself.
I do this 24/7,
dude,
too. That's all I know. On the computer, everybody knows.
Yeah, but I mean, do we have pickle jars full of hash?
No.
Okay. Tubs, for sure. But not pickle jars.
You know what?
Matt has tubs. Matt has tubs like this, and he runs a huge facility. Oh my goodness, I think this one's full. Okay, so I have tubs too. But that's...
Okay, wait a second here.
It's very hard to grow just a simple gram of full melt resin for yourself every day.
Like the problems you come into with disease
and this
and blah.
Resin.
I want a 12x12 room, and I really and plants that I
Do you think you grow 365 grams of resin?
No way.
A full melt? That's what I'm saying. And you're working your ass off. You got a big grow.
I got like 11 different strains because I have different medicines and stuff.
Still, what I'm saying is it's not enough medicine for the amount of work that you're putting in.
No.
And many people won't be in that situation to do that. So it has to be, and I've gone back to this a few times, I like the idea of letting everyone play. You know, so... The reason the government gets involved and the reason there are licenses for such things, just like there is in the food and alcohol and other industries, is due to the fact that standardizations need to be in place to protect the end user,
yes,
buyer, whatever you want to call them, or her. Wouldn't you agree?
100%. Everything is set into place because they look at getting something where it's not going to be dangerous to the public,
yeah,
or anything like that. Where they're not producing molds,
dude,
or pesticides,
exactly,
or anything.
Exactly.
I mean, I'm all for a certain system where we're able to get
a system
that standardizes.
Exactly.
Right? But
Which,
I mean,
what does that mean?
Time,
it means that when you've got a beautiful crop and you find out there's a bug or a mold or a mildew or a microbiological whatever, you got to get rid of that crop. And no one in the herb world does that.
No.
They would need to be forced to do such a thing. And the reason they would need to be forced is through something like standardizations. If you know your shit's going to be tested and you know your shit's contaminated, you're not going to try and bring that forward to be tested.
100%. And when we're dealing with big commercial facilities, dealing with,
sure,
the public, yeah, but not my own personal grow when I
no.
got my own little
well,
thing
that's,
for myself.
That's why I think this. Guys like you and me who want to grow for ourselves, we maintain our licenses, we don't pay big money for it, and we don't sell our herb or hash, okay? Next in line, at the other end of the line, you have what the Canadian government is trying to push through right now, which is licensed producers, which in my opinion isn't really fair to everyone that would want to be a licensed producer because they're making the investment so huge, you know, $3 to $8 million
Stage
or whatever.
Stage 8 security,
yeah,
just ridiculous.
Massive security, and it just seems to be that they're making it also very hard on that end. Those guys have paid for their licenses big money. So they've paid the price to be able to sell cannabis, to be able to put everything in place, and to be able to control their standards to a point where it'll pass the tests. Okay, fine, I'm good with that too. But then in the middle, what we need is the microbreweries.
Yes.
We need the small-time grower that's bigger than John and I that does want to sell his or her works for a little bit of profit because they're a great grower with great genetics.
They love
and
their passion.
They
want to help people.
They want to help people. But
they just love
listen,
what they do.
There's a ton of people that love growing weed that want to help people, and I'm telling you, a huge percentage of them would not pass the standards of what is going to be in place. The standards of having no microbials and no powdery mildews and no bugs. And that's a hard thing to...
It's definitely, it's a hard thing.
It changes the game.
I'm in the middle of winter and I'm going to go biological and I have to get predator mites because I'm getting a little bit like, where they come from?
Damn.
You know, it's just like, it is hard and it is when you come down to sterilization. I know you were talking about how you completely cleaned your whole tent.
I had to.
You wiped it down with bleach. I was
yeah.
doing the same thing.
Really?
I'm wiping down everything in my room. I'm going to pick everything out. I'm going to be that guy that's going to
yeah.
have to like shut everything down, kill everything, redo everything from seed, and then go ahead again because of the infestation that I...
And what a great lesson in the sense, why would anyone fight that experience? Because that experience is what's going to push you throughout the other side so much stronger as an individual, as a grower, as someone that, like, okay, like, if you can't maintain and control something, then it's time to clean everything out. And that's another great reason, when things are healthy and you've got your moms, for God's sakes, give those clones away. Give those cuts away to people that are you know.
You know what? I mean, a lot of research on that, and a lot of people are looking at the clones for looking at for different yields and the different efficacies. But I mean, like you say, when I do more and more reading, growing from seed is just more beneficial and more rewarding for any, a lot of your small time growers. You get some seeds.
Oh, growing
going
from
on.
Seed is awesome.
Bigger growers, of course,
when
are definitely
you're not worried
going
about
for
profit margin, you know. But then again, clones are nice in the sense that
once you find that genetic and it's perfect for you, because I found my genetic.
And to share it, like the way you just brought me my 20-year-old Jamaican seed today. Like, that's, I wouldn't have been as stoked had you brought me seeds of my 20-year-old.
Totally.
I would have been stoked for you to have the seeds,
yeah,
but I would
have
been like, oh, like, it would have been good to have that.
Yes.
And then the story would be like, oh, you know.
But you would definitely, every seed has a different efficacy, a different pharmacology.
Sure,
yes, say.
Absolutely.
So, of course, that Jamaican seed, there's only that one type of profile.
Mm.
So, 100%.
Okay, yeah, on that note. Well, what the hell should we do today? Should we go to Mega Ill and eat some pizza?
I think we're going to be doing something here. We're definitely going to do something for 2015 that's just going to be more about celebrating this new year. I'm quite excited to see what's going to be happening with cannabis for 2015. There's a lot of hype around it. There's a lot of big stars behind it. There's a lot of controversy and actually a lot of positive notes going on with cannabis for 2015. I do believe
True.
This year is going to be one of the biggest years we see with complete or slowly legalization being happening all over the country, all over the world, I should say.
Yeah, man. Good prophecy. Speaking of prophecy, I was speaking with him in the new year in St. Thomas, Jamaica. Very good to hear from Prophecy. For those of you that don't know, Prophecy is a good friend of ours down in Jamaica, an artist. You can check him out on YouTube by Googling Prophecy. And either Puff and Pass, a video that I cut for him in Jamaica. John was there. You might even be in the video. And
in the far field.
Excellent. Yeah, that's right. And Body Bags, a track that he did as well. Both those tracks are great. He's got a new album coming out, and we love Prophecy. We love to support Prophecy and shout him out.
We love Jamaica, man.
Yeah, we'll see you next time we are in Jamrock, which I wish was in a couple of days, because I believe it's going to be Tony Rebel's birthday again really soon. I posted a little article on Facebook today about from the lawyer. What was his name now? We should know the right names. Let me go through my computer here that seems to turn itself off and quickly show you this little article that was written. It's basically talking about how reggae artists and the Rastafarian people that have promoted and supported and frontlined cannabis use and the availability, et cetera, et cetera, for decades to past now, should have a space reserved for them in all of this.
Well, I mean, for what?
So he wrote, legalize it. This is Lloyd, what's his name? Lloyd Stanbury. You can check him out on. He's a Florida-based attorney and music business consultant. And he wrote, his belief is that reggae artists, especially Rastafarians, should be afforded a special place in the future of marijuana in Jamaica and globally for their steadfast endeavors towards herbs decriminalization. And so you can check out that article through my Facebook, or you can Google Legalize It, Marijuana's Relationship with Reggae and Its Future Prospects in Jamaica. Yeah, I think it's got some potential.
Awesome.
You know, yeah. It's
yeah, I haven't had a chance to look at it. I was driving.
Yeah, oh yeah, right. You were driving here, and then halfway here, you were like, oh, I gotta go back to a doctor's appointment.
Yeah, I gotta call her. And I was like, I got a reminder on my phone. I love that. It's one of those things. It reminds me. It's like, wait a second, turn around.
Yeah, it's good to have a reminder. You might need earlier reminders. Now that you've had that, you've realized, man, maybe
give me half an hour.
You can get multiple ones.
I might need an hour.
That's the purpose. Or two, where you get like 1-2 hours, or even three. Look, why not right in the morning when you wake up? Hey, there it is. Forget about it a couple dabs later. Get another reminder.
But I get up in the morning. The only thing I have to remember is that yoga starts at 9:15.
There you go. Yeah, that's great to hear that you've been keeping up with your yoga.
Oh,
I'm sure it's only going to do... I think that... I will say this. You will see John start looking better and better and become healthier and healthier as he does more and more of this yoga. There's just no avoiding it.
Well, it just... You know, I'm learning so much, and it's great to be able to feel how I am and stuff like that. And of course, it just comes a lot to just dedication and learning how to deal with your pain. This is one more reason than how I deal with my my pain.
It's facing it, right?
Exactly.
It really is facing it more so than covering it up. Or I mean, you go into your pain with yoga. No medication takes you into your pain. You go in on a cellular level, and then you use your breath and your blood to
clean
kind
it.
Of milk that pain.
To milk that pain.
That emotional.
I went in with a broken toe yesterday, and you know, it was something amazing that yoga can do for you is exactly what you're saying. It's just like you said to me. You said it to me for a long time, and then I did it, and
glad you did.
Thank you again.
Yeah, dude. No
you
problem.
Know,
thank you, Christian, for turning me on. He asked me every day for 2 years.
And once again, I. Christian is, I'm pretty sure that I met when I first fell, so I have to go down and remember when I first got my accident. I walked into a yoga studio back in 2006, and I just walked out. It was on Commercial Drive where you were talking about
I can't
friend.
Believe how close you
And it took me that long to get
us.
Back in there. Yeah, I know.
We were just next door like a year prior. Well, good.
Sometimes
I'm glad.
Let's go do some stuff.
Yeah, we're going to go do some stuff. We're taking you guys with us. Puff Wednesday's on, so please roll up some joints. Pack some bowls, heat up your electric nails, fill your torches, and let's get this Puff Wednesday started.
Let's get going.
You know what's cool about it? All right, so just starting the ride here, and it is a beautiful day out on the Howe Sound. If you actually Google Global News Horseshoe Bay, January 7th, dolphins and whales. There was hundreds of dolphins and I guess a couple of whales that were spotted, and they made a little video about it today, just south of my house in Horseshoe Bay, just where you catch the ferry to go to Vancouver Island, to Bowen Island, and to the Sunshine Coast. So we're just heading down what is known as the Sea to Sky Highway. This highway takes you from Vancouver to Whistler and to Pemberton, past Squamish, past, you know, well, really Pemberton, I guess, is the end, and then it ends at the Duffy Road. Just thought you guys might find that a little bit interesting. And apparently there's an inversion today, so we're going to see an incredible weather inversion with the fog, i.e. the clouds, pushed down below the mountains. So I'll show you guys a little bit of that when we get to it. So apparently this inversion stopped planes from leaving Vancouver Harbor today, and it caused some delays and maybe even some cancellations of ferries. So here we are coming out of the sun and into the fog. So what John and I have decided to do, instead of heading right to Mega Ill, is that we're gonna go burn about an hour up on the top of Cypress, spend 5 or 10 minutes with you guys up there, show you the lookout right now, and show you what it looks like above all this fog. Hopefully it looks really cool. I'm expecting that it's just gonna be all clouds and no city and barely any mountains. So we'll see you up there in a bit. The road up to Cypress Mountain, one of the local ski resorts. We've got three just overlooking Vancouver in the north and north side of Vancouver. So we have Seymour, Grouse, and Cypress. And this is the furthest one over to the west, closest to, I guess, West Vancouver. I guess it is in West Vancouver, actually, in this particular one. So we're heading up this road, and it goes for a few kilometers up, and this is the early part of the road, so it's not very steep, but it will get into an extremely steep grade very soon, 18% or something, somewhere around there. It looks good. It looks like we're getting out of the fog and into the sun. So we're probably only going to be a few hundred meters above the sun in our lookout, but it's going to be awesome. You guys will dig it for sure. This is a great place to get a view of Vancouver from above. If you're like a tourist, not from here, and you want to check it out, make the short trip to Cypress Mountain lookout. All right. Coming out in the sun. That's what I'm talking about right there. Clarity. Oh my God. I just looked to the right. You guys are not going to believe this. All right. We're heading up to the turn here. We're going to turn into the lookout. And I don't want to ruin the surprise for you. So I'm not going to show you guys what it looks like right away. I'm going to give you a little tease as we pull into the parking lot. So here we go. There's Johnny B. Ah, Johnny B. How are ye, Johnny B?
Oh, getting a bowl ready?
Look at this.
Dude, we're getting bowls ready.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
We came here to dab.
We came here to
puff. Dude, how about that weather inversion, boys? Sucks for sledding, but great for video. Shit!
Where the way how? I mean, here, that's the best part. See where that mountain is?
Yeah, that's Mount Baker.
That's where I live.
All right, so let's go check out Johnny's spot.
And it's sunny there, and it's sunny at your place.
Actually, you know what? Let's grab the tripod and we'll walk them over there. Unbelievable weather inversion. Beautiful weather inversion. That's what I'm talking about right there. Weather inverted.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Hey, would you guys take a picture of us three?
All right, so there's the mountain Johnny was talking about, Mount Baker. Off in the distance, looking slightly epic. Doesn't that look epic?
Dude, so I wake up sick to that every morning, that mountain.
Mount Baker. That's your mountain. And that mountain is in the U.S.
So you're going to wait around?
It's great for snowboarding, that mountain.
I don't think so.
Look at beautiful.
Well, it is. See, I think we're in the mountains.
Pretty sick footage, eh, John?
Hmm?
Pretty sick footage.
Well, here we are, guys. We made it up the mountain. I was talking a little bit in the truck, as you heard. You were my nice silent cameraman. Thank you for that. So yeah, we're up here at Cypress Mountain at the halfway point. It's probably not even quite the halfway point. You're gonna hear a lot of cars going by because we're around a major turn. There's even, in fact, a bus coming by that's probably gonna drown out all sound in about 3 minutes, or I should say 10 seconds.
Here we go.
So let's load a bowl. Bad as I thought it was going to be, because he's going uphill. I thought it was going to be pretty bad. I'm just making sure that I have everything organized for the dab. And as you can see, we have a weather inversion up here. I wasn't lying. It's absolutely beautiful. Over this corner, there's a tree in our way, so we're not filming this way, but Mount Baker, which I showed you in the video earlier, the mountain that's very close to John's place in Abbotsford. And you can see Vancouver Island in the background. That whole mountain range is Vancouver Island. And in front of that, we basically just got clouds. Clouds covering the entire city of Vancouver right now, which is going to be pretty cool, because we're about to head in there to go to Mega Ill and have a serious puff down.
Serious puff down. And some good food.
Yeah, well, you know, sometime in the next hour, because we got to enjoy this for a bit. And we got to hit that.
Thanks, brother. Well, that's like sitting on the side of a... You know, you got to be able to medicate when you're able to medicate. It's just one of those perfect spots where it's... I was talking today about the effects of your mood and how cannabis affects your mood. When you see something like this and such enjoyment, along with a nice bong, it makes you just feel so much more lovely.
Agreed. So that was wonderful. Would you like to heat that up again and we'll get you one of those?
I would definitely like to do one.
A little dab will do you, Johnny B, on Puff Wednesday.
On a Puff Wednesday, the first Puff Wednesday of 2015.
In Cypress Provincial Park.
What a way to do that.
Dude, I'm representing Trichome Heavy Extracts.
The guy over there has a smile as you walk by.
Shout out to Jibs and to Ken and the whole River Rock Dash United crew, United Cannabis crew. All right, here we go, Johnny B for the Congo Longo.
have a reason for you, buddy.
What a beautiful day it turned out to be after spending a week up in Whistler, where it was, you know, cold, not really, really cold, but obviously you guys saw that we were in bobsleds and we were on snowboards and we were in on snowmobiles and in tube parks and whatnot. So it's definitely nice to be in the warmth right now.
Yes.
I mean, what is it, 10, 12 degrees out? 15 degrees?
It's maybe up here, but not down there.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's an inversion up here, right? It's really nice.
Beautiful. I woke up to sunshine, of course, when I got to your place. The sun was shining when we came around the corner. My eyes big. Gorgeous. Oh.
CBD Renee?
Okay, Renee.
Let's hit it.
Notice how that just changed everything?
Yeah, it's going to change everything, you know? Whoops, what am I doing?
Can you heat the front right here right now?
Sure. You can see John's no rookie when it comes to letting me know where he's heating the nail, because if I don't pay attention to that, which I haven't been, and in fact, if he didn't tell me, I probably wouldn't know, then you put the dab in the wrong spot, and it doesn't heat up properly.
And of course, you know what, it's always good that you let the person that you're heating anything up to, or sharing your medicine with, or bong rips, or your whatever. Just communications, everything, man. It really is. It's about communication.
I do. A little bit cool on that spot, but just heat her up a bit, and we'll get you your freshie. Oh, wow. My gosh, it tastes like candy.
I know. I just like, okay, just a little tiny dab, nothing major, just a nice little pick me up. It's more of a refresher than enlightens your. Yes. A little nice little small dab. I'm happy.
Johnny B. Puff Wednesday, Cypress Provincial Park, Trichome Heavy Extracts, River Rock, Bubble Bags, Medtainers, Skiing, Snowboarding, DNA Genetics, Unity in the Community, Flav 421, Matt the Great Gardener. I could keep going for Polish hours. Keep going, you're burning up there.
Oh, sorry.
No problem. Awesome. All right, well, we're going to continue to do this as we do. And we'll bring you with us when we leave and take you to Mega El Pizza. For now, let's just enjoy that view.
Just amazing.
Heading down, and there's really beautiful golds and blues coming out through the sky and through the trees. Not sure if you guys can catch that. Thank you, buddy. Hey guys, Bubble Man here.
Yeah.
And Johnny B. I got it right. And you can see in between us is Mega Il Pizza right across the street. They got themselves a nice big sign. And we're about to head on over there for some medicated pizza.
Damn right.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. That's pretty dead in there.
Perfect.
There you go.
All right, people are letting us go. Like a few people. The other people are driving as fast as they can.
Well, you know what? They got a little bit to go.
They're going to stop right away. So here we are at, look at that, hemp pizza.
Hemp pizza.
They got the hemp pizza now? Well, let's check it out. Boom, 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 boom. Hello. So, Bubble Man and Johnny B here inside the Mega Ill. We've just learned that there's some new rules at Mega Ill, and so we're going to let the gentleman...
Matt.
Matt and...
Amit.
They're going to tell us.
They're going to tell us more about what's going on here.
So, all right, guys. How's it going?
Good.
Excellent. So, take us through this. Take us through the changes. Take us through... how we go about ordering some medicated pizza from Mega Ill.
So basically now you can put your order in here, and if you want to smoke, you do it next door, and this is our non-smoking side, so you can bring the whole family. We have some new pizzas to choose from as well.
Nice, yeah. Some thicker crust on some of those, eh?
Yeah, oh yeah, yeah.
So we got medicated and non-medicated pizza for families. So if mom and dad want to be able to medicate, they can have the kids' pizza and they can be all happy.
Yeah, exactly. And every dose is tracked, so no one's going to get a mix-up with any pizza.
Excellent.
It's all with your name and your card number and everything. So.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yes.
Very cool. So what do? Sign up for a membership or something?
No, we accept most of the local cards. So if you had an Eden card, a Red Med card, a Medicaid card.
MMAR card.
MMAR we accept. Doctor's note.
All right.
Bring that down.
We're in. So we've got our MMARs. So we're good to go, John.
We're good to go.
We should be allowed to order pizza.
Apparently I still have my MMAR.
Yeah, as long as we keep fighting the good fight.
There you go.
So maybe we should order some pizza here, Johnny B.
Well,
what do you say?
Yeah? We already know that you're going for the full-on vegetarian.
I don't know. That pierogi looks pretty good. I would just lose the bacon. But that's like sour cream, hash browns, green onions, caramelized onions, cheddar. That's wild. Plain Jane mozzarella. Plain Jane is my favorite, I have to say. I do love me a good plain Jane. Super cheese is nuts.
Nice. The super cheese looks pretty nuts.
Isn't it?
It's really good.
Oh, that's like an eight incher. Should we share a super cheese, John?
Sure.
Get a super cheese to share, and then do you want to get another pizza? I think I'm going to order a plain Jane.
You're going for two?
Yeah, just a small.
Two personals?
I'll get a small personal for myself, and then we can share the super cheese. Just get half.
That sounds good to me.
And then you can also order yourself another wonderful pizza if you like.
You know what? Look at this. Remember to eat walnuts, avocado, caramel, onion, basil, arugula, sliced apple.
Sounds like your style, John.
Automatic reduction, fresh grated parmesan. I love pizza. Caramelized onion, artichoke, roasted.
Rambo, that's what you got last time, I think.
Yeah. You know what?
You should probably try something new.
I have to try something new. And this Eden looks pretty amazing.
That's really good.
Garden of Eden.
A little bit of Garden of Eden. Tree of life. That's what we're going for.
Okay,
yeah,
so
I'm gonna have a little small Eden.
Okay, so personal plain Jane, personal Eden, and a large super cheese.
Yeah.
No, personal super cheese, just a small.
Yeah.
Oh, just a personal super
not
cheese?
Not a large. Yeah, because we're
personals?
Well, yeah, like a personal each and a half.
Yeah,
well, I'm good to go.
Dude.
I thought we were like, maybe sharing.
We'll be good. All three of them will be medicated.
You know what happens when we start medicating? I always think large already, because I already know once I start eating pizza, I'm going to start doing some dabs, I'm going to get more hungry, and it might be maybe.
That's why we're getting 1.5.
Oh, that's right, yeah. 1.5 edition.
And then we're gonna go smoke next door.
There we should set up the D-nail next door and have everything ready. What do you think?
Yeah, well, we'll do that. Should we pay for our pizzas right now here or what?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Okay. The future.
Medicate me. All right, we're gonna go next door and set up. You guys can make our pizzas.
Yes.
Thanks, brother.
Where is?
All right, so Johnny and I just got to Mega Chill. What's up, dude?
Hello, hi.
Right on. What's your name?
Benny.
Excellent, Benny. Good to meet you, man. Hand it out. So I see you got a little dab bar set up over here.
Mini Morpheus.
A little Mini Morpheus in the house. Know. What's up, Mini Morpheus?
Mini Morpheus.
What's up, dude? Ready to blaze?
He even got the same marking on his ear.
You want to blaze?
Because I'd like to cook.
Shay, what's going on, man? So they got a little dab bar set up here. This is lovely.
Look at this. I'm like really stoked here, man. Back it out. Ready to go. We got a D-nail already going on over there.
I love it. And it's a 2.0.
This one's confusing me, but I'm pretty sure I'll figure it out pretty soon. Oh, that's why.
Here you go.
Look at that.
My cable.
We're going to double up here. Okay.
My 2.0. My new whip. My new whip.
The new whip. Yeah,
have you checked out my new whip?
That's nice. I saw that. I was like, what the hell?
I kind of have to admit, I really still miss this one. This gold one. Yeah, you see how it sits straight all the time?
Yeah.
This one's curled forever.
So that way it stops it from kinking.
Well, it just kinked, and now I can't get it unkinked, so it's not the end of the world, but we'll get a highly educated, and so this one I just brought. It's the brand new one, so it might be a little different than the one you have. In the quartz bowl.
Here we go.
Get rid of this guy.
We got Rocky playing in the background. He can watch us. We got Horatio in the house.
Horatio? Dude, how's it going?
Hey,
How's it going, dude?
We're already filming.
Did you just...
I said we should have gotten pizza, eh?
We're already filming.
Didn't I already say that?
What? We'll just go order one right away.
Do you need a pizza?
Of course I need.
Well, what kind of pizza would you like?
Non-exotic.
Let's go next door and order a pizza. Yeah, Horatio needs a pizza too.
Good.
You have to get him a pizza right away too.
Sure.
So grab him a menu.
We go,
get him a plain Jane.
Plain Jane.
Plain Jane.
Plain Jane.
Okay. Plain Jane. I'll
grab
put that on right away.
Yeah. Right here. Look, he's got a little pipe on the side.
Oh no. Uh-oh. Oh, I'll turn that on.
That's the next thing to turn off.
Yeah. Perfect. Next thing to
just
turn
push through. Record and
Perfect.
Okay.
All right, so we've got ourselves all set up here at Mega Chill. I was a little bit shocked when I went to Mega Ill, and he was like, oh no, you can't set up your thing. We're not really allowing smoking, and the health department or whatever said no smoking. But they still allowed them to medicate pizza, which I thought was really cool. Then he brought us over to Mega Chill, which is literally attached to Mega Ill, right next door. We've got a little dispensary here and a dab bar set up, so John and myself and Horatio, we each have our own D-nail set up. Well, I guess Matt's got one set up on the side there. He'll have to lean in every once in a while and say hi.
I might grab that.
But yeah, we're set up. Our pizzas are getting cooked right now. And I guess so too should we.
So I'm able to grab this D-nail here. Well, thank you, Matt.
No,
it's good. Congo Bongo.
Let's do this up. Let's puff bowls.
Make it chill. What's the heat on?
It's
977? Yeah, we're definitely going to turn that one down to about 741.
I should hit it on that, right?
I can't hit it on that.
What do you got over there?
Can I
hit
what?
I can't hit LHO after. Oh. I never mix weight.
Oh, okay.
I learned that from you.
That makes sense.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a nice thing.
I don't have a
second. So do you have two?
No, I clean my rig every time I want to switch.
So you guys have to clean your ring about 3 or 4 times a day at least.
The water. Oh, you need water.
The bong needs water.
Everyone gets a dry pull eventually.
Everyone, the last time John and I came to Mega Ill, this is a funny story. We puffed the whole video. Probably puffed about 25 bowls. And there was no water in the bong. Yeah, it's a wide angle lens, so you're in for sure.
Okay, so we're just gonna watch that one.
What is it? Turned up too hot or something?
Yeah, it's at like 900.
Oh wow, mine's up at 730, and people say it's too hot. You're rocking 350.
Oh yeah, low and slow.
Low and slow.
It's a long dab.
I'm gonna get it right in the middle.
It's not even my wife. It's only for people who have long deep chest.
I wouldn't say 720.
Otherwise,
I like 420. I like some TV. He's checking things out over there, of course. Mini Morpheus.
I brought you some Congo King if you want to check that out.
Oh, yeah.
My Congo King.
Yes, you please hit the Congo. Oh, yeah, you want me to do it?
Yeah, we always.
This is Matt. Matt's Congo.
I'm just doing something over here. So this is, what's that temperature over there? We're okay with it.
Johnny's got the temperature.
I put it to 740.
Well, pretty much 900. Kills him.
900 is a bit hot for sure. A little bit hot.
It definitely vaporized instantly. Like, gone. Like, that was like. Oh, wait.
I had a few people bitching at me recently for heating up the quartz banger that I got. This quartz banger I got is 3.5 mm thick. It's the thickest one I've ever seen. I should have brought it. So I heat it up, and I don't really get it to orange hot. I just heat it up so it's close to orange, and then. You know, I hit the hit fairly soon right after. Well, people on YouTube are flipping.
45 seconds!
Dude, 30 seconds at least! I'm just like, dude, like, I think if you were here hitting this, you would understand. Because I understand low dab temperatures. I've hit from 350 up. I think it works much better for oil.
Absolutely.
You know, the super, super low, but
it's either 20 more degrees for a super, super low sift hit. Minimum.
Really?
Or else, I can't finish
70
it.
70 for a sift hit might be a little high.
I jump up 20 degrees to 3, that's Celsius, so that's 370 Celsius for sift, 350 sift for
Celsius,
oil.
So that's basically 700 and some Fahrenheit, which,
yeah.
Which that perfectly up right over here, so you know what, very, very happy. That means I can hit this dry sift right now.
But it's also,
thank you
it's
for
a 40 second pull, so.
Very nice.
Cuckoo.
It's still have oats.
Yeah, make sure that I don't steal your these. These things are like lighters, you guys. When you see one of these, you hold on to it. It's like your most precious.
I was like, wow, that's
true.
New. I like it.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah, it's that little that. Do you have any of the CBD Renee left?
Yeah.
That's the one I want to. As long as we get into it before. Let me get a sniff draw.
That might be my little pony joke. Try some.
I'm
okay,
well,
come on over here.
You first?
A little bit of Warlock.
Afghani, Justin Trudeau 15, and Congo 90.
That is so
I got Matt off the side here. We got his head so covered good. In that.
Oh, dude, trust me. I was tripping on it. And it doesn't even smell nearly as strong as it did smell.
No, it's... Smell this. Now, your nose is why I bring it here, but just smell that edge compared to the CBD Renee.
And what's this one?
That's Pineapple Express. That's the closest smell. It's not the same, but when it comes to relation, that's the closest relation I've ever gotten.
And what's this strain of Pineapple Express?
Pineapple Express is Hawaiian times train wreck.
Mm.
That's kind of why I smelled that and I'm like, well, the CBD Renee isn't related, but it's really, really fresh smelling. So
yeah.
it's maybe it's just that fruity freshness that jumped out, why it seems so much liver than, you know, your typical bud smell. It just smelled real fruity.
That's a little flavor from the last pineapple. So which was it?
Well, there's different, there's always different lights, there's different growing methods, and
yeah.
So if I can get a chance to even try the same strain from two different growers.
And is that limonene extract?
Oh, absolutely, I don't use green tea, so. Yeah, so that's the LHO Pineapple Express, but its smell, just, it's wet. It seemed like a real fruity, where everything is more just the smell of weed plus a scent.
Mm.
But the CBD Renee seemed that same mouth-watering.
I gotta bite this. I might try to bite
I might try to. That's exactly what it is.
But it is almost the anti-resin in the sense that it kind of clears the palate. It's kind of like you're getting high, and then you hit this, and you're like, oh, I feel like I'm.
That's why I'm going to. At a certain time after a certain amount of time, I'm going to reset.
What
are
you hitting today, John?
Oh, hi. Just tried that.
Oh, nice, yeah. Yes, the CBD Renee, absolutely excellent. I thought you were hitting some of this.
No, go ahead, try.
I don't want to take your last hit.
That's okay, I'll probably make more. This is part of the half stash in 2014, so it's like...
You trying to erase the past?
No, you know what, it's, sometimes it is what it is, and there's a little bit of goodness in there.
Trying to puff the past.
Yeah,
puff the past.
Clear the slate, so
you gotta crack
working.
Those seeds, you gotta puff that hash, you gotta enjoy it.
Seems to be growing season for get that strain, either put it into flour. I mean, I'm still
I'm
picking
through. I'm going to grow into flour myself.
Yeah.
Just with a few plants, but Johnny brought a few more by today. I've got my buddy Tim dropping a few more off, and D420K was going to get me a few. So basically all the folks that I've been sharing cuts with, I'm just going to...
Yeah, everyone's getting loaded.
Here's a couple back at you.
Well, you got to get them back there.
For sure.
Yeah, that's important.
My tents are cleaned, and I mean cleaned.
Sorry, I'm laughing because of the squeaky chair, so you might hear this a little bit through the video.
The squeaky chair?
Yeah, see. You're going to see me very still here, guys. Like,
we're having a little bit of a squeaky chair puff down here. That mega chill.
Mega chill.
Yeah, but I definitely think everybody, even on Facebook, everyone's like, this year, squeaky clean, as many standards. I want it, everything I do to go whether it's hash,
well,
whether...
Because
it seems like
finally, you know, the folks like ourselves who are OCD and just have these sort of standards set upon us through the need, not the want.
Mm-hmm.
We need it to be that way. It's like we have a disease or something. Oh, it's like a mental illness or something. I like it personally.
Mm-hmm.
But other people don't need it, but now they want it. So I'm happy with that. You know, that it's kind of come around that people are like, they actually want standards. Because, man, when I started doing this, people were like, whatever, man, I'll just smoke weed.
I think it's the change
that's
from...
what people said to me when I was doing it, when you were showing me, they're like...
Well, they'll still say it today, but they just, not anywhere as near... Well, put it this way, dab bars didn't exist.
For sure.
People didn't have dab bars. There was no like mega real pizza place to go get medicated pizza.
Well, it's
dab.
Once cannabis, once we all got the recognition, it's medical. We're not just getting high. Then everyone was like, well, if it's my medicine, well, I don't want my medicine to have a cat hair in it. Well,
I know. My
medicine. So within the producer and the individual, everyone's like, God, it's somebody else is relying on me. So what is that guy saying that's OCD? OCD people are usually the ones that write regulations. So
right.
If you can learn it and pick it up on YouTube, then fuck yeah. Adopt it, take it in, and apply it in your own life. It's not going to choke you. It's probably going to take out a bit of the choke out of your head.
True. How's the sorrel?
It, Jarritos. It's good.
The cane sugar.
Hibiscus.
Just
natural
one more
sugar.
Bonus when you're here at Mega Chill and Mega Ill. They've got these sort of natural cane sugar drinks.
Okay, so I'm drinking the Bonji mango.
Mas fruta.
So this, I just did a rip of this.
I like how you have your finger up.
Yeah.
Well,
it's
very like...
We're at dinner.
Dude, it was awesome. He was just so chill about it. He doesn't Mega Chill. It's just
I think we've got some same mercine effect.
A little mercine.
Carry over your mango.
See?
Right. Well,
what do you
color.
Think? I'm just passing.
No, it's not. It's a mango. You know exactly
today.
What
about,
it's
about. About those different essential oils and.
About we're Canadians.
About.
Yeah.
So what John was talking about.
About. I'm talking about as a pizza coming around the corner here. Smells like the deal.
I still have the tiniest little taste here.
So this is the particular number two phenol, and it tastes so good.
Thank you.
Move some of our hash. We're gonna move hash.
I think it's time to move hash.
I think it's time to move some hash.
Let's put it in the middle. We got pizzas.
Dude, he's used to a camera. Oh. He's done this before. Which one is this?
Plain Jane.
I got a Plain Jane.
And this is Eden.
And a little bit of Eden.
So you have Plain Jane.
Plain Jane.
And
yes.
Then the Medicated.
And the Medicated.
Awesome. Excellent. You can put that right here.
I'll just take it.
Oh, yeah. So you're
going to... He's like, I'll take that. Thank you.
And so, wow. Just in case you're wondering if it's medicated, there's a giant M made out of dough right in the middle.
Enjoy,
of the pizza.
Guys.
Thank you. This smells amazing.
Here, let's put this one down here.
I think
now.
We should eat the trap pizza.
Well, here, let's go.
Do it up. I'm just diving right in.
Give her.
I'm gonna rip.
Nice.
A piece of the M
as well.
I like it. So this one in particular has hash.
Do you want the M? You got the M. I just gave you the M.
Okay.
I got the M.
Oh, yeah. Medicated with CBD, Renee. Yep.
Tricep.
All right, safe bet for driving home.
Mm-hmm.
At least you know you are. Well,
very nice. Natural crust. What kind of crust you guys got going on?
It's an imported Italian flour mixed with a whole wheat stone mill. And then a little bit of semolina, give it a little kick, and yeah, little hemp parts, can't go wrong.
I almost thought there were some hemp parts in there.
Yeah.
I'm just going to ask if there's some little bit of hemp in there.
Yeah.
Along with the infused on.
Yeah. Can't go wrong with hemp parts.
No, exactly.
I think the relationship between the cannabinoids and essential amino acids will be very... interesting to see unveiled in the upcoming decade and more in the science and the
pretty much where cannabis starts to draw in everything else it would naturally want you to do to get better and get healthier and stronger. So compared to a soda, to pull in the mango juice is just the natural thing that comes with cannabis education and research.
For sure.
What did the cat take out of my bag?
Nice job. Here's some natural flavor. We definitely have the cat going after. See, this is what's great. This cat is actually trained to go after the hash.
I like that.
Pass it over to Grace. Cute extras.
Yeah, I can't afford to let the kitty going through my bag. Get too medicated.
Very good. Nice pizza.
We're going to continue to eat, and we'll catch up with you guys in a bit.
I'm going to dab.
Now, what's this one? Turks?
That's right.
This is the Turks.
This is the Turks.
So that's pineapple.
Interesting.
So now with...
Yep, smells very, very similar. Terps. I haven't personally gotten to play myself. How much plant matter did it take for you to get that?
1 pound.
1 pound.
Yeah, to get about 3 grams of pure terps.
Wow.
And this is not all the terps from the plant. These, what I was aiming for was the type of terps we lose in the drying process.
Right.
And seeing
so
if
a
I
pound get, fresh.
A pound fresh.
Okay.
Well then 5 pounds fresh makes 1 pound dry.
Yeah.
So going off of it that way, this is the water from the actual plant. This isn't terps swirled around in water and then invigorated in the water. This
right.
is actually the sweated out water from the plant. And then this is the alcohol in the water as a separate fraction from this water.
Okay, and how did you go about going through these processes, if you don't mind sharing?
Well, you could say what I got was a big mass of this cloud. And then I started... the fractional distillation process that I'm using to pretty much, I knew I could potentially split it.
Yeah.
So you get this big massive cloud, and then out of that you can pull out the clean water, and then out of both you can pull out the isolated terpenes of just the floral essence. So these are the most volatile. So even
right.
if I freeze this, this is going to do what you smell when you freeze sip.
Right.
The most on fire, God, if I keep this up, it's going to burn off material. So even this will ruin my hands for the night. But still, in the normal bud that remains is all the terpenes that make up pineapple stress. So these are only lost terpenes. That's kind of why I had that question for Tony. Is it all of G13, or is it just what G13 loses from bubble hash, dry sifting, curing,
yeah.
or the other process?
I think he'll have to explain that in a way when he explains what he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll be really when people have a fuller understanding. I know one thing is that, I'm not sure about these two, but the pure terps, they have special lids.
Mm-hmm.
And the inside of the lid, Tony had them, they're just, they don't dissolve from the
Well, this is, terps. Yeah, this is pretty much the last of my steam distillation set from 2004 glass vials. But normally, I would either keep them in a state where they could never hit the lid in a long tube, corked. But I didn't expect anything to work. So when you don't expect things to work, you don't typically have what you need ready to bottle.
Yeah, true enough. Well, very cool that you managed to get all that done. The three levels of terp water are very interesting. Terp water to cloudy to pure.
Mm-hmm. This is the one, because when I take a swig of this, this is the one that's got that bitter medicine taste, where this just, oh yeah, that's really nice. I could pay for that in multiple ways, as rose water, any other essence. This is the strong stuff that everyone's fighting for, and there's no known value to the price, because when you start splitting them off, and it's not just, let's say, tangy, 99% limony, 3% mystery elements,
right.
but this is a bottle of those mystery elements. There's no known value.
Sure.
Yeah, because these are all perfumes that have only been made by the plant.
Mm-hmm.
We're not doing anything weird. So this is going to be a magical future in which every strain, if I can keep this process up, starts again, because this becomes literally what's in the grove.
Right.
This is as close as it gets. I'm like, I smelled that. I wasn't planning on it today, but...
Definitely smells just like pure terps.
I was going to bring you a frozen bud so that you could check out an undried bud.
Oh, yeah.
And then get a snipped off and go, okay, that... I smell there, break it up. No, that's not there. That must be what remains in the bud. And you start
your floral essence.
So that's what I'm excited about, because a lot of us never ever get to experience live plants. And that's a whole nother therapeutic experience that's just like roses and going in any garden. So bringing that to the forefront, you know it, you guys take it for granted. I smell it and I'm like, that's like that one time I was privileged enough to smell it for real.
Absolutely. Yeah, well, I have a little stash of it, and it's awesome. I'm glad you brought it today.
I was privileged enough to try it. It was very nice.
Excellent. Well, I just hit an Afghani hit, and it rocked me wonderfully. I felt mildly affected by my medicated pizza, which was also very nice.
It's perfect.
A little CBD Rene dry sift. Take it.
Can I get some of that CBD Rene? I'm ready. I said I wanted to wait till I was a little bit more...
Nice.
A little bit more...
You nice.
A little bit more.
So very cool. Very, very cool stuff. I was actually just off on the back, kind of zooming in with the camera.
I just want the CBD.
You just want the CBD.
You're doing whatever Wake and Bake, and it's like, CBD Rene is getting us ripped, but in a new, different way, and... Hey, you gonna see me today? I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna see your CBD today.
Nice
carb action on that. Well, that's why the nail's sitting a bit funny.
As you're doing that, I'm gonna jump into this.
Yeah, tasty treats. Good times. Hanging out with buddies at Mega Hill and Mega Chill. Medicated pizzas. D-Nail bar. Pretty sweet.
Yeah, that CBD. It's that taste. It's the one taste that could bring us all to being sober at the end of the night if we kept. I like that taste more than I like getting high, if that's what it costs.
It's a really nice taste.
Mm.
There's no doubt about it. It's, it's just you never know what you're going to get when you're crossing these strains. I know that Matt's working on some other interesting things right now.
Yeah.
That we'll probably see in the near future. Maybe the next time I go visit House of the Great Gardener, we'll catch up with him and see what's going on over there. But for now, I think I'm going to say Puff Wednesday was killer. We managed to puff a fair bit of bowls.
We puffed.
Eat a medicated pizza. Get above the clouds for a weather inversion.
That was pretty cool. We haven't seen that. Like,
bump into Horatio, who literally drove an hour and a half to get here.
In the blaze of snow.
In the
blaze of snow. He was on the other side of that.
Humans can detect that down to 0.24 ppm. So we're programmed to find that smell if it's the last thing they do on Earth.
Right.
So when I learned that, I'm like, holy shit, that's how the fuck am I going to ever beat a demon like that?
So we just tasted the two waters. This water was very much like water.
Yeah.
Like really florally. Yeah, like really
yeah, floral water.
Essence
yeah,
of water. Nice, tasty. Reminiscent of... Oh, almost a little bit came out there. Reminiscent of bubble water,
mm-hmm.
But clear. Like literally clear water.
That's kind of the first thing I wanted to know. I'm like, how far is this off the new bubble water? Because this is what I meant by, you're not going to get the terps back out of this. To get the terps back out of this, you're still going to end up with water. It's just an ever-ending loop. This is what me and Tony agreed on. You can't get it out of this. And when you first said, could you get the terps out of the bubble water? I'm like, if there's floating oil from broken heads, I can filter that out. But I'm not getting this back. This is when I looked at that machine and I'm like, we're getting too crazy. Why don't we just...
I bet you one day we'll get it back.
This is the kind of thing...
That's what Kay was telling me. He was like...
I feel like we have it back, and you drank it, and you could have taken it after your hit, and it would have been a natural...
But you know what I mean? To extract those flavors out of there, and then get them into a pure form without the
water. That's the question. So we have these flavors, which... Did these flavors impregnate the water?
Right.
Or are these separate flavors than the original terp? Because rose, everything has, in steam distillation, leaves the water as tainted. So
sure.
You steam roses, steam oranges, steam pine,
makes
that
sense.
Water is always there. And it's more, so you know in that case, it's like a tea. It's an imbued essence.
This is very tea-like. This one had a bite.
Yeah, that's why I, because when alcohol mixes with water, it gets cloudy. Everything comes out with that bite, and then so everything looked like this, and then I pulled this and this out of it so that a different texture. I'm like, that's just water, because I get way less of this, way less, so it's pretty much in proportion.
We should do that video. That's the stuff people want to see.
It's,
if it doesn't cost 15 grand to do, which it doesn't, fractional distillation does not cost 15 grand to
there's
do.
fractional distillation, there's so many fractions. That's a fraction of what you pulled off of through the pipe.
Sure.
Which exhale is a fraction, which inhale is a fraction. So it shouldn't be an intimidating term, although
right.
it can become an
well,
intimidating
sure,
apparatus.
Can, of course,
so
you can go pretty deep with it. Like even these,
that
these
could
are,
get
these,
split.
These are terpenes. So these aren't pure terpene.
Yeah.
There's many, many, many terpenes in here.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's ways of exactly separating those all out. I think that's cool too. That would be really neat because once we could get those all separated.
It's one of those mixed bags. They've been separating them for ages, but the used chemical is way not,
well,
way
I've,
not
and
in line
and
with.
And I've smelled the ones they've used from plants and stuff.
Yeah.
I'm just interested in doing it with cannabis.
That's
extracting cannabis terpenes in pure form and then fractionally.
Well, this is what I mean by this is a fraction of the floral essence. Then I go home and I have all the bud in which there's a whole other fraction that could come out because I didn't. This is no temperature
right.
process. So this is one fraction, and then
well, it's all about the process, right? Say
yeah.
we one day come up with a process though,
yeah,
that allows us to pull 100% of the terpenes out of the plant,
mm-hmm.
and then we then can take that and literally, just like with bubble bags, separate it into all of its pure terpene forms. That would be amazing to just have that little kit, crack it open.
Well,
have
that was what I was going to say. I was like, that's doable, but what would be amazing if it was affordable?
Well, yeah, that's the part that's not affordable.
Even the fact that I'm here with this, I'm like, well, even as I say this, I'm like, what I did is a blessing of the privilege I have.
Mm-hmm.
But people watching at home, I'm like, this isn't affordable. This isn't do it. I have a luxury to be able to recombobulate. Just like when we saw Tony get ahead of that, I'm like, he's got a privilege that I don't have. When I get my privilege, it's mine. But for the home user,
you'd be surprised how many home users could see something and then be like, I'm going to come up with something that does that very,
well,
just
I,
to understand the concept.
Well, I absolutely know you can get a percentage. It's not exact. It's not exactly terps, and it's not exactly oil floating on your water.
Right.
Because when you get that broken head, you got your terp.
Sure.
It opened up that trichome head. We know that. And now you've got the released oil and the terp, but they are at different densities.
Right.
So when that mass is floating on the water, it gets trapped within your plant material. But if I can filter out that water, that plant material, I'll eventually get back to water with oil floating on top.
Well,
so
I'm telling
that's
you,
doable.
We should show it one day, because, man, I'm telling you, people would love to see that.
All we need, I mean, to try the bubble water route, all we need is...
I've
the
got,
first thing was...
I've got fresh
that was the first thing is, I was like,
yeah,
dude, do you understand?
I
have no bubble water to try this with. Tony does.
I got
he has but that's the many levels of it. So what we get out of the bubble water won't even be this, because it's from dried bud, but it will be more.
Yeah, Tony's isn't from bubble water that I know of. I think that he did some other thing with, he was calling it whole plant.
Mm-hmm. So that's kind of why I'm interested. I'm like, Tony went the whole plant. I went for the lost fraction because I wanted to see, no one smoked this. What if we introduced it to the pizza box? What if we introduced it, unfortunately, I didn't get to do the sift from the bud I made this from in
right.
time. It's on my 70 screen. It's waiting for that last 2 hours of work.
Mm-hmm.
But I got the text to come down to Mega Chill because that was it. Seeing what is even the sift like from the bud that remains? Does it come out true to strain?
Right.
Because that means we could take that sift and still run it through Tony's process and get a whole different. Lots of ways to get fractions. Lots of ways.
True that.
I mean, even when we low temperature dab, we're getting a fraction and missing another.
Well, you can just see here by looking at it, the different colors of all three bottles.
Mm-hmm.
Where the oil is more, you can see it's more. I mean,
it's bending light differently.
It's bending light differently, exactly. So you can already see just by looking at it, and I have tasted all three, where the water was, like you said, very floral, where I found that the second one gave me a numb feeling in my mouth.
Absolutely, because it's...
My mouth went all
it
numb.
It is cannabis alcohol terpene.
Cannabis alcohol. So that's why I got that feeling, and I know the effect I get from taking a pure terpene, because you did give me that one drop on the first day, which was... It was interesting. It was just that the flavor was amazing.
Mm.
And it wasn't as hard as what Tony gave me. And the only reason why is that Tony just gave me a lot more.
Well,
but I felt
would,
that same effect.
That
in,
was the
in,
first
in
thing
the
I said. I'm like, you can maybe do that with the floral essence, but I wouldn't do that with thyme oil. I wouldn't do that with menthol. I wouldn't do that with limonene oil. One drop isn't one drop. That's kind of why I was like, well, if it's the whole plant, one drop could be a totally long blowout experience.
Oh,
but
yeah.
This is like the lady essence that us men, as we smell it, this is what makes us girly and go into our gardens. This, it's so light, it's so nothing, but it's burnt into your memory more than something that's just loud and kill, because it's light and it's lily-like.
Yep. Terps.
Terps.
Terps at Mega Chill.
Let me turn it off.
Okay. Oh, good and baked. I think I might go drive over somewhere else.
Hey man, the world's yours when the cops can be shut off with a power button.
Some serious editing going on here.
I'm unarmed though. This one's a caddy. Ooh, there's an Audi in the corner though.
Make sure there's some hash in the glove box.
Dude, fucking A, it's an R8.
Oh, you got a sweet ass car.
Holy shit. I'm stoked.
Save it to disk, dude. We can take it home.
I almost messed this shit up. I'm gonna be careful or pop it, you
know? Really?
Yeah.
Wow. I'm doing a good job.
I need to do some smoking.
What are you hitting? I thought you were smoking something.
No, that's what I was. Yeah, but then we did a whole. No, not on camera. I put away my camera.
Oh, I got my light.
Mega Chill medical cannabis menu. Got some shatters in the top there, some butters, some other shatters. Got some medicated stonuts. Get stonutted. Some tinctures, multibars, some candy, gummies. A little rock, a little platinum. That looks really nice, man. I mean, shit. That's real darn nice. I have to admit, I didn't think you were going to pull something out quite as nice as that. Be very careful only to touch the stalks. I did get a little talking to last time when I was a little... Awesome. And that is the Rock, Platinum Rock MKU?
Yes.
Sweet.
Yes, I never stopped doing that. That's what I meant by I don't know how much I have.
What else you got? East Coast Sour Diesel, Coma, Sandman Coma, Bubba Death, Rock, PK Ripper, the Klondike, the RMK. Which one's that?
Some the Rumpelstiltskin.
Ah, yes, the Rumpelstiltskin. We gotta get you some more hashes in here, man.
We have.
I see your Afghan Press hash, yeah. Cubo hash there. Sweet. How much for the medicated sativa gummies?
$7.
For a bag?
Yes.
Cool. How much is in each one?
Dosage wise?
Yeah.
I think approximately 100 milligrams.
Okay, cool. Thanks, dude.
You're very welcome.
But yeah, thanks, Matt. Good folks here at Mega Ill and Mega Chill for showing us the hospitality, and yeah, I think we're just gonna continue puffing bowls, but we'll end Puff Wednesday for now and say thanks for watching.